is offering up a $1,000 reward for information leading to an arrest. PETA has actually offered up a $5,000 reward on top of that for information. So if you saw something, please say something. That's
it. Any other comments, Brian?
So briefly, the parade was great. Great job by the administration for putting that together. And of course, hats off to the boys. I think there was a lot of people out there who had a really nice time. But I always say, you know, everybody wants to come together for a parade. It was nice that everyone was out, but there's very important things that need to be done. And if everyone would come together like that for city issues, even though they're not as exciting, maybe we could move this city forward faster and more positively. So just a heads up on that one. Upcoming events, we have the Great American Cleanup coming up in the next couple weeks. I'm just going to continue to trumpet that because it's an opportunity for everybody to come together, volunteer, clean some stuff up, do some really nice things for the community. Speaking to the Velodrome, it is a nice event that we have something huge like that coming to Reading. But we do have a nice downhill coming to City Park. I believe it's the first week in May. It's the third annual Reading Downhill Bike Race. It should be a good time. It always is. There's a lot of people going to be looking at that mountain and enjoying a good time in City Park and on that mountain. So I hope that all of us still continue to make efforts to do a lot of good things. And last of all, I know that Coach Perez is getting a lot of recognition. I happen to know him personally, and I really I don't think he can get enough credit because I know what he's done. I remember when he first started coaching and he just was reading books, trying to figure out how to, you know, learn the right defenses and offenses. But obviously, when you hear them children speak and you hear what they're saying and you hear that what he speaks about with all the passion, it's that love and his passion and what he did along with his coaching staff. But primarily, he was the leader. And I'm super proud of looking at him and seeing what he did for them kids. And I mean, if more people can understand that just that little effort by one person can expand and grow to great leaps and bounds depending on what you do, I'm just going to continue to always spread that positivity. So hats off to him personally, Rick Perez. Great job, man. Really great job.
All right. I'm just going to make a quick comment. You know, and I'm very tired of allergies tonight, so just pardon me if I, and the first thing I want to say is I don't want to offend anybody, and it's not my intent to do that, but, you know, I've been around this table long enough, and sometimes, you know, I remind people this is really a spiritual experience, and my hope is as we make decisions that we all just kind of clear our minds out of all the noise and try to look at each issue for what it really is. And, you know, try to kind of fend off all the outside influences if we can. And we're never going to be perfect at that. I'm not expecting anybody to be. I'm certainly not. But I try. I try to look at the issues and make a decision based on the issue. And sometimes I feel energy. I see in people's eyes, though they're saying one thing, I'm feeling another. And, you know, just an opportunity for me tonight to express that to everyone is, as we move forward on this journey as short-time representatives of our city, that we continue to listen closely to what our spirit is guiding us with and make the best decisions based on that. And again, that's not directed at anybody. It's directed to me as well. You know, it's directed to everyone. So just had to express that, even though I'm tired. You know, just felt the need to do that. So real quickly, our meeting schedule, Thursday at 4 o'clock, we do have the termination hearing, so I'm hoping everyone can be here for that. I know everyone's excited to go to the Reading Phillies opener. Afterwards, next Monday night here in City Hall, we have our nominations and appointments committee at 4 o'clock, our committee of the whole meeting in the Penn Room at 5 o'clock. And in 2 weeks from today, we have our committee of the whole in the Penn Room at 5 o'clock and our next business meeting here in council chambers at 7 o'clock. If there's no other business, can we have a motion to adjourn? Thank you.